Christmas at Wollaton is back again this year, and if you're in Nottingham, this event is a not to miss. Every year, there's something completely different, and this year's train is probably my favourite. So join me, Gabe and Lay, as we explore this trail at Christmas at Wollaton. Hi everyone, my name is Rakshit. It's been a while and I'm back with making another video. This time we're taking through a really unique experience. I'm here with Gabe and Lay and we are going to Christmas at Wollaton to check out the lighting again. It's been 2 years since I made this video and I'm really excited to see how it's what it's like inside. So let's go in and have a look. The trail begins with the tunnel of light into the field of flames, where you can see little lamps glowing. And of course, given the freezing weather the day we visited, we had to make a stop for a cup of hot chocolate. It was absolutely delicious, I must say. With the press of the colored button, we shoot lights at the light launchers to color the trees in front of us. The Wollaton Hall Gardens was transformed by 15 key zones, which created a multi-sensory festive spectacle with brand new attractions, as well as the loved classics. Well, this year's event is a lot more calm and collected as compared to the last time I came here. It's such a relaxing experience to walk through. And well, guess what? They've got the same deer that they had the last time. These deers just look like a constellation of stars, absolutely spectacular. The glowing lamps and the shining trees. This whole area reminded me of the previous time I came down to Winter Wonderland when it was snowing, and my memories of building a snowman next to the tactile gardens remains to this day. And of course, this lighting experience was all thanks to a collaboration between Luminism as well as award-winning creative director Catherine Jukes, who designed the experiences for Twitter and BBC. Well, it's time to step into Christmas. Hop on these lights to create your own music. As we enter Robin Hood Roses, I felt a lot more relaxed. The trail continued onto the fire pit stop, which was just behind the Wollaton Hall. And as always, the Wollaton Hall was glowing with colorful lights as the experience presented Sun et Lumière show on the building. Well, the next pit stop had not only hot chocolate but also a pit for toasting marshmallows if you're into it. The trail took us towards the Laser Garden, which was my favorite last year, where they were laser shooting into smog created by a fog machine. This brought us towards the end of the trail. Let's hear what Gabe and Lay had to say.
What do you think?
I would say good, solid 8 out of 10. No, I was just doing it.
Yeah, we've come to the end of the tour of Christmas at Wollaton. So it was a really nice experience. And of course, there's a merry-go-round and a slide just beside me. This video hasn't been sponsored, but we did get free tickets from Christmas at Wollaton team to discover and explore this new trail. This sure was a memorable experience for all of us, and we had to make a quick stop at Christmas at Wollaton Christmas Fair. This Christmas market had a lot less merchandise than last year, but a lot of food options, which I really appreciated. Churros, donuts, hot chocolate, coffee, and so much more. Well, thank you for watching this video. Please like, subscribe, and don't forget to follow me for more amazing videos like this.